Hey guys, Nick here again, back to talk about The Walking Dead Season 7 finale, called The First Day of the Rest of Your Life. And I'm just going to come right out and say it. This was the best episode of the season. At least to me. It was my favorite episode, at the very least. I mean, it was just... This is the episode that us loyal fans have been waiting for almost 6 months now, and they hit this one out of the park, in my opinion. I mean, the episode, it's an hour and a half long, and the first hour is build-up, but very well done build-up. It's building tension, and there's moments where... I actually found myself shaking at a few moments in just the buildup of the episode. So, let's just get right into it, because I got a lot of stuff to talk about. The first thing is, Sasha and her, storyline. And, we got to see a flashback of her with Abraham, and I love how I chose to wear my Abraham shirt for my reaction, and Abraham showed up. I didn't know that was gonna happen. I really didn't know that. But it was so nice to see Abraham again. It was nice to see them together, because we never really got to see them as a couple, because right as their romance was starting to heat up, he met Lucille. And just the flashbacks were very well done. It was very emotional, very well acted, both Sonequa and Michael. They both did a great job. And when they both appeared on the Talking Dead finale afterwards, I was a wreck. I almost broke down watching Talking Dead because of that. That was just such a nice moment. It was nice to see my man again. Abraham was one of my favorite characters, and I miss him. Speaking of people that it's nice to see again, Rick is back. I mean, we got a taste of it in the second to last episode when he was taking the guns from Oceanside, but he is 100% back now. Just the guy that's not afraid of anything or anyone, including Negan. I mean, Negan straight up told him he was going to kill Carl in front of him and crush his hands with Lucille. And Rick he barely reacted to it. I mean, okay, I can't say he barely reacted, because I did see a tear come down his face when he said that he was gonna kill Carl. But still, Rick was just like, "There is nothing you can do to change the fact that you're already dead." So yeah, it was just so nice to see Rick again. I mean, the Rick that I fell in love with. The Rick that became my favorite character on the show. Like, the first two seasons or so, I kind of went back and forth with who my favorite character was. Like, sometimes it was Rick, sometimes it was Daryl, sometimes it was Glenn, sometimes it was Herschel. But at the end of the day, seven seasons in, overall, I gotta say Rick. I gotta say Rick's my favorite character. Now, of course, there was the beginning of the episode where we saw Dwight kneeling before Rick, and admittedly, I was still skeptical, I guess. I mean, to an extent, as skeptical as I could be. I know what happens in the comics, but they don't always stick to the comics. So, I still can never know for sure who's gonna do what. And honestly, by the end of that scene, listening to Dwight, I realized this guy is most likely telling the truth. And despite Tara's insistence, I'm glad that Daryl didn't kill him. Of course, Daryl says he's just gonna kill him anyway when all is said and done. Well, we'll see. Now, let's get to the big one. big climax of the episode and of the season, really. The gunfight. Where everyone was involved. I mean, that's another thing. Everyone was in this episode. And everyone got some focus. The only main character, by which I mean the only actor who was credited for every episode but didn't appear, was Gregory. And honestly, who cares? No one likes Gregory. I think it is entirely possible that Gregory is more hated than Spencer was. Which is saying something. But yeah, everyone else was in the episode. And almost all of them got some dialogue. The only character I don't think got any actual dialogue in the episode was Father Gabriel. But even still, he got his moment to shine, just like everyone else. I mean, Gabriel was taking on the saviors and the trash people. Don't even get me started on them. Or my brother. If you watch part two of my reaction, you can hear how he felt about Jadis and her people. But yeah, it was nice to see Gabriel. Like, Gabriel's come so far, and I just, every time I see him, I like him more. And he's shooting at all the bad guys with an assault rifle, like, without any hesitation. Then, of course, we got to see Carol and Morgan make their proper comeback. Like, they've both been relatively out of commission for this season, particularly Carol. Morgan, actually, he had been a little more in commission this season when he killed Richard. And when he started sharpening his staff into a spear, we knew that he was gonna take it up another level. And then Daryl got his hands on some kind of weird, futuristic Call of Duty Infinite Warfare-looking gun and was just gunning down without remorse, which was awesome. Michonne was fighting the lady that I thought was Tamiel in my reaction. I was wrong. I found that out afterwards. In fact, I kind of figured it out during the episode. I was like, oh, that's Tamiel, isn't it, standing behind Jadis as Negan has Rick and Carl lined up. Speaking of Carl, Carl got the first shot. Carl fired the first shot of the war. When Sasha came out of the casket, which, I mean, that was that whole thing was really well done, and I loved it all, but having read the comics, I knew it was probably coming. Sasha is not in the comics, but there's a character that goes through that same story arc, for lack of a better word. I mean, not exactly the same, but unexpectedly emerges as a walker. And honestly, I think it was a little more believable on the show than the way it was done in the comics, because in the comics, what happened was the character was delivered back to Alexandria by the Saviors, and this person was already a walker, but there was a bag over her head. Okay, yeah, it was a woman, that's all I'll say. And there was a bag over her head, and when she made her way to the other Alexandrians, and the bag was removed from her head, she was revealed to be undead and bit somebody. And to be honest, when I read that, I'm like, they couldn't hear this walker growling? Like, I don't know how that worked. So, the show really fixed that one. So yeah, those are, like, all those characters, they got a ton of awesome moments. Everyone really did, but there were two characters on this show that truly just stole the show for me. Ezekiel and Shiva. I mean, if you saw my reaction, you know that I freaked out. Moments like that are why I started filming my reactions. Just, I was hoping I'd see something like that. And just something like that to film my reaction to. That's what I'd been waiting for this whole season. When Shiva just emerged and pounced on that guy and just bit his face off, that was just, oh god, it was so awesome. That was the payoff for all the patient fans that stuck with this season for 16 episodes, despite its rather slow pace. That was the reward. And Ezekiel emerging with all his people saying, Alexandria will not fall! Not on this day! Like, in that moment, and just a combination of that and sicking Shiva on the saviors, he officially earned the title of king in this episode. Because before, he was really just a weirdo with a tiger. And he's king because he has a tiger. No one is going to mess with this guy. But here, he proved that he was the king. And just, it was so nice because this whole season, we have been seeing everybody just lose. No matter what they tried against Negan, something happened. Either Negan's tactical superiority or just pure luck. Whatever it was, something happened that saved Negan's life. But here, even though, okay, Negan didn't die here. He did escape, uninjured. But still, he got his first L. Okay, this has been a season of W's for Negan. But he finally got an L for this one. But even though he lost, he still managed to get a couple of pretty amusing reactions in. Like when the hilltop emerged, which was another awesome moment. And he saw Maggie and realized that she wasn't dead. He was like, the widow's alive! Guns a-blazing! That's my impression of the lean. Just kind of shoulders back. So, yeah, that was funny. Just a look on his face when he saw Maggie. And then, of course, when he's driving away and he's flipping everybody off. That was great. Like, he may have lost this one, but that was I'm sure that was a good moment for him. And, something I totally skipped over. I meant to talk about. Even though Dwight seems legit, like, he held up his end of the bargain. He said he'd cut down the tree on the road to slow the saviors down, and he did. But, although I now think that Dwight is on their side, on top of the little chess piece, I guess, that he left for Daryl that said, didn't know. I guess he just left it for whoever found it, but Daryl just happened to be the one to find it. So, like, even though I think I can trust Dwight, I'm not sure how trustworthy Eugene is, because every time we've seen him since he joined Team Negan, he just seems to be a little drunker on the Kool-Aid each time. And I can't help but wonder if next season, I'm sure Dwight's gonna go to Eugene and enlist his help to help Rick's people to take down Negan. I'm not sure that Eugene is gonna be 100% on board with that. I mean, this whole time I've been saying, Eugene, he's still on the level, he's still a good guy, but I don't know anymore. Overall, I do still think that he can come around, but I think he will at least, he'll at least question himself. He'll question if he wants to stay loyal to Negan or Rick. And personally, I'm looking forward to that little conflict. And the end of this episode where Rick was around Michonne recovering from her vicious fight with the heapster in the tower. And Maggie giving a speech about how it's only because of Glenn that they're all here. They're all together as family. Just all that done together was just, it was really beautiful. I really liked it. It was really well done. And it ended with some hope. Like, this season started with misery. And it was mostly misery the whole time, but we finally got a glimmer of hope. My only concern is that I'm a little worried that, like, there's a chance that next season won't be able to maintain the traction that the show found with this finale, because that kind of happened in the first half of the season. The last two episodes were really good. I'm like, okay, it's finally found its footing. But then the second half of the season was actually not as good as the first half, which I thought would be a difficult thing to do, but... I mean, look, I didn't hate this season, but it's kind of the reverse of Season 6, in my opinion. Season 6 was an overall good, if kind of inconsistent, season. Like, there were a lot of really good episodes, but then, of course, there was the finale. And there were a few other episodes, like, the mid-season finale was not great either. But overall, Season 6 was a good season with a horrible finale. But Season 7 was okay, but it had a great finale. I mean, best of all, there was no cliffhanger. So, you know, obviously I'm anxiously awaiting the next season, but I'm not, like, angry at the show for leaving me hanging as to who's dead. So, that's a relief. This season didn't end mid-scene. There was closure. Like, Season 6 ended with, like, a hook to pull you back in. Like, just like, oh, you're gonna have to tune back in now. But this one, this season's finale is making me want to come back, which is the way you need to do it. Like, this was how you do a season finale. This is how you end a season. This is how you break out of the rut that the show has been in. And obviously, I am giving this episode a 10 out of 10. It was fantastic, and I loved every second of it. So that'll do it for my review of this. I'll probably do a review of Season 7 as a whole at some point. I've got a few ideas for videos in mind. I was thinking maybe I'd do a countdown of the best episodes. I mean, maybe do a countdown of my favorite episodes, which is not necessarily the same. Favorite episodes are just episodes that I love and can rewatch over and over again. Best episodes is ones that are really well made, but aren't quite as rewatchable, mostly because some of the most well-made episodes of this show are pretty depressing. And I was thinking of also maybe doing a countdown of the best characters on the show. Like, I got some stuff in mind. I'll be here doing this before October. And also, I made a compilation reaction. I mean, I don't mean I made one myself. I appeared in one. Leon Andrew Raison compilations. And... okay, I'll admit that I messaged him and said, hey, I got my reactions here if you want to consider me. So yeah, I'll admit I did some campaigning to get in it, but still, I didn't think I actually would. There's a lot of people that do reactions out there, so I was really surprised to see that I made it, and I'm really grateful for that. So go check that out, Leon Andrew Raison compilations. I think I'll put the link to that in the description of this video. Alright, so that'll do it for now, and I'll see you soon.